I can't see anything. Put the power back on.
So let's rerun this scene, but this time when the power fails, let's introduce emergency lighting.
There we go. I think we clearly demonstrated there the importance of emergency lighting. And in this video, we're going to look at lighting from JCC that can illuminate this area as well as offer emergency lighting.
Well, Gary, it looks like you've just lost your excuse for not being able to clean up because somebody's switched the lights off. The emergency version seems to have that covered for you.
It does, and we're going to be looking at the Toughbay light fittings from JCC in this presentation. We'll go back to the one in the unit because there's some other clever features that one's got. But what have we got in front of us here, Gordon?
Yeah, okay, we've got the other two versions in the range. So here's our sort of, there's the basic version, which is obviously a high performance, high bay light, and it's dimmable via a 1 to 10 volt supply.
Okay, yeah.
Normally you'd couple that with a microwave sensor on the side. And we've got the version you've just seen, the emergency version here, that doesn't have the sensor. So that obviously means the one we've got installed in the unit has the microwave sensor fitted to it.
So it's got all three. So it's the light, the emergency pack, and the microwave sensor. And you can buy any of those combinations within the actual set that JCC provide. That's really good. Now, I found you playing with this in the unit next door, didn't I?
Yeah, I did. Now that's, yeah, you like that because it's just a remote control. Now I say just a remote control because there's one thing Gary doesn't like and that's apps.
I don't like apps, no, but I do like a remote control, but you snatched it off me and you dove in there and you're going to show us all the great features that this offers.
Let's have a look. Okay, so before we look at the functions on this JCC remote control for the Toughbay, why do we need a control in the first place? Well, I'm stood down here. The light is up there. The last thing we want to do is have to get access equipment out to make adjustments to a lighting control system because the way we've used the space has changed. So infrared remote control talking to this microwave occupancy sensor. What can we set on it? Well, let's look at the simplest one. It's the on-off function. So here's, we're on, there you go, we're off. So this control is talking to individual light fittings one at a time. You might get an overlap if you've got two fittings close together. What can you set on it? Well, out of the box, you've got four quick setup functions that set some of the common scenarios that you may need in a high bay application. Then we think about detection area. So how big an area is the microwave occupancy sensing covering? So you can set that between 100% and 25%. Next up, we think about hold time. So how long will the light stay at 100% once it's been triggered by the occupancy sensor? So we can set that between 30 minutes or as short as 5 seconds. Then we have a feature, standby dim level. So say we leave the space, we don't want the light possibly to go all the way off, or perhaps we want a delay to allow us to exit the building, or perhaps we want a standby lighting level. So we never want the light to go off. So we can set that between 50% and 10%. We can test it on this remote control. So I'll just do that now. So here's 50% and there's my dim level there. Or perhaps I want to go lower and go to 10%. I can test that as well. And then we can set the time it stays in that standby period. So that can be, it always stays there. So it's on all the time. Or we can set it to say 10 seconds. And so I'm going to do a little trial now. So perhaps we'll just set our detection area at 25%. I'll set the hold time to 5 seconds and I'll set that standby period before it switches off at 10 seconds. And then I'll leave the area and watch what happens. So that was really easy to set up. Simple, don't need to make any adjustments up in the air. We can further add to the energy saving potential of the system by enabling the daylight level sensing. So the light fitting itself will detect the amount of ambient light in the area. Perhaps there's a lot of daylight coming in through the roof, or perhaps you've left some doors open, meaning the light won't operate if a high level of ambient light is detected. All in all, really simple remote control, very easy to set up, great energy savings.
So it seems it was your turn to have a little bit of fun with the remote control, which works straight out of the box. So that was our first attempt at using it, and that was really simple.
Yeah, so let's possibly have a look at some of the spec features that are pretty important when you're choosing a high bay light. So we've got 150 watt versions here. This one outputs 18,400 lumens. You can step up to 200 watts at 24,500 lumens. Or down to 100 watts at 12,300 lumens, depending on the size of the space that you're lighting.
Okay.
For you, Gary, that means lots
of
light.
Yeah.
So good for all industrial applications. This version comes in 60, 90, and 120 degree beam angle versions. And in terms of toughness, they're all IK10. So that's pretty robust. So that's going to be good in a lot of applications where you may have some rough service.
Okay, so if it's IK10, what about the IP rating?
So it's IP65. So again, not going to have any problems with getting dust in there. In terms of the unit here, so this is the basic on-off version, but it's not on-off because it's also dimmable as well. So mains connection here, we've connected that to this junction box here. There's the two 0 to 10 volt wires that you'd connect to the microwave sensor that we've just seen we demonstrate in the unit. Here's the emergency option. So on the back of the emergency option, we've got the battery pack itself. Now it's all pre-wired together. That's all the versions. So if it had the occupancy sensor, that would be pre-wired as well. And you just make a simple connection to it with this IP rated connector. So
okay.
You just unscrew the barrel and you've got your four connections in there for your permanent switch, live, neutral, and CPC.
Oh wow, so they thought of everything. That's so super simple then. Hang it up, just connect it, and we're done.
Yeah, so batteries are kept away from the high bay, so you don't have any heat issues there itself. Charge indicator visible from the ground. You'll notice when we switched it off there, you could clearly see the charge indicator was on. We could even see our remote control lit up under the charge indicator.
So when I was looking through the data sheet, I think you can get a bracket to mount it on the wall. Am I right in thinking that?
You can, yeah. So there's another option on the side there. Obviously, if you couldn't hang it from a roof where high bays normally live, and perhaps one on the side, there is a bracket to do that as well.
And I know they work from minus 30 to 45 degrees and come with a 5-year warranty as well, don't they?
Yeah. Okay, you don't work at those temperature ranges, Gary. I've seen your output tail off at the low end and the high end. So yeah, you wouldn't put up with that. So yeah, works with that and 5-year warranty.
Yeah. Yeah, which is really good. But as always, we're interested in your comments. Have you been fitting this Toughbay fitting from JCC? Are you thinking about fitting it in the future? Is there any other products in the JCC range that you want to leave in the comments below for our community, because there's an absolute gem in there and you want them to know? We'll try and get back to as many of the comments as you leave as possible.